From DocuSign, Go Live Part 1, Getting Started. In this video, I'll discuss the background for the Go Live process, whether or not your application needs Go Live, and more. The Go Live process helps to maintain the stability of the DocuSign platform by checking your application's use of the DocuSign APIs. The Go Live process is part of DocuSign's audited security processes. Go Live also helps DocuSign customers, developers, and ISVs, independent software vendors, by confirming that their application is not receiving API errors from DocuSign. After Go Live, once your application is live in production, DocuSign continues to check your application to ensure that it is using the APIs correctly. The Go Live process is required for all integration keys before their applications are allowed to use the production platforms. There are no exceptions to the Go Live policy. Even DocuSign's own applications must pass the go-live process before they can be used with the production platforms. The good news is that you will probably pass go-live on your first try, or if not, then you'll pass on a subsequent test. This video series covers all of the common go-live issues. Please allow adequate time for the go-live process. I recommend planning for a week-long process. Go-live can go faster and usually does, but it can also take much longer than a week when application changes are needed. Most developers do not need to change their applications to pass Go Live, but some must update their apps before they can complete the Go Live checks. The more you understand about the Go Live process and the DocuSign API rules, the better equipped you will be to pass Go Live the first time. Even if all steps go well the first time, it can take up to 3 business days to complete Go Live, since it includes a manual audit step. Business days do not include Saturdays, Sundays, or holidays in Washington State, USA. Some more good news. In many cases, Go Live does not apply to you or your application. If the application's integration key belongs to someone else, such as an ISV, then Go Live does not apply to you. If you purchased or received a DocuSign application from someone else, ask them if you need to provide a DocuSign integration key for the application. If not, then either the application doesn't need an integration key, or the key is managed by someone else. It is common for applications that are purchased from an ISV to have the application's integration key managed by the ISV themselves. But there are some ISV applications which require you to provide your own application key. In these cases, the ISV should also provide instructions to you for sending test transactions and passing the go-live process. Applications that use the DocuSign Connect webhook feature may or may not need to pass go-live. If the application only uses Connect notification messages, then no integration key is needed, and Go Live is not needed either. Many Connect applications use the webhook notification message to trigger one or more calls to a DocuSign API. In this case, you'll need an integration key to call the API, so your application must pass the Go Live process as well. You cannot use access tokens from the DocuSign Access Token Generator for your application during the Go Live test or in production. The Access Token Generator is an optional tool for use during the first phases of development before you've implemented OAuth for your application. After Go Live, you will have 2 integration keys, one in production, one in the developer sandbox. The 2 integration keys have the same code, but are separate. They can be used simultaneously, each in its own environment. Each has its own configuration settings, secrets, redirect URIs, and so forth. One is managed from your developer sandbox account, the same as before. The new one is managed from the production account you select during the Go Live process. After your application is in production, continue to test your application in the developer sandbox, the demo platform, since DocuSign releases multiple software updates every month. Before each update, DocuSign checks thousands of regression tests, but your application might still be affected by a change. DocuSign recommends that you implement automated testing and continue to test your application with the developer sandbox system every week or every day to avoid surprises. If your automated testing discovers an unexpected breaking change, please contact DocuSign customer support immediately. Please check out the next video in this series to get ready for the Go Live process. Thanks for tuning in. Please subscribe to this channel and click the bell to be notified when we post new videos. Thank you very much.